Chapter 14 of The Tin Woodman of Oz by L. Frank Baum. Chapter 14 The Green Monkey. They now entered the house, and as an interested group, watched Ginger, at Ozma's command, build a fire and put a kettle of water over to boil. The ruler of Oz stood before the fire, silent and grave, while the others, realizing that an important ceremony of magic was about to be performed, stood quietly in the background, so as not to interrupt Ozma's proceedings. Only Polychrome kept going in and coming out, humming softly to herself as she danced, for the Rainbow's Daughter could not keep still for long, and the four walls of a room always made her nervous and ill at ease. She moved so noiselessly, however, that her movements were like the shifting of sunbeams and did not annoy anyone. When the water in the kettle bubbled, Ozma drew from her bosom two tiny packets containing powders. These powders she threw into the kettle, and after briskly stirring the contents with a branch from a macaroon bush, Ozma poured the mystic broth upon a broad platter which Ginger had placed upon the table. As the broth cooled, it became as silver, reflecting all objects from its smooth surface like a mirror. While her companions gathered around the table, eagerly attentive, and Dorothy even held little Toto in her arms that he might see, Ozma waved her wand over the mirror-like surface. At once it reflected the interior of Yoop Castle, and in the big hall sat Mrs. Yoop in her best embroidered silken robes, engaged in weaving a new lace apron to replace the one she had lost. The giantess seemed rather uneasy, as if she had a faint idea that someone was spying upon her, for she kept looking behind her and this way and that, as though expecting danger from an unknown source. Perhaps some Yookoohoo instinct warned her. Woot saw that she had escaped from her room by some of the magical means at her disposal after her prisoners had escaped her. She was now occupying the big hall of her castle as she used to do. Also, Woot thought, from the cruel expression on the face of the giantess, that she was planning revenge on them as soon as her new magic apron was finished. But Ozma was now making passes over the platter with her silver wand, and presently the form of the giantess began to shrink in size and to change its shape. And now in her place sat the form of Woot the Wanderer. And as if suddenly realizing her transformation, Mrs. Yoop threw down her work and rushed to a looking-glass that stood against the wall of her room. When she saw the boy's form reflected as her own, she grew violently angry and dashed her head against the mirror, smashing it to atoms. Just then Ozma was busy with her magic wand, making strange figures, and she had also placed her left hand firmly upon the shoulder of the green monkey. So now, as all eyes were turned upon the platter, the form of Mrs. Yoop gradually changed again. She was slowly transformed into the green monkey, and at the same time Woot slowly regained his natural form. It was quite a surprise to them all when they raised their eyes from the platter and saw Woot the Wanderer standing beside Ozma. And then they glanced at the platter again. It reflected nothing more than the walls of the room in Ginger's house in which they stood. The magic ceremonial was ended, and Ozma of Oz had triumphed over the wicked giantess. "What will become of her, I wonder?" said Dorothy as she drew a long breath. "She will always remain a green monkey," replied Ozma, "and in that form she will be unable to perform any magical arts whatsoever. She need not be unhappy, however, and as she lives all alone in her castle, She probably won't mind the transformation very much, after she gets used to it." "Anyhow, it serves her right," declared Dorothy, and all agreed with her. "But," said the kind-hearted Tin Woodman, "I'm afraid the Green Monkey will starve, for Mrs. Yoop used to get her food by magic. And now that the magic is taken away from her, what can she eat?" "Why, she'll eat what other monkeys do," returned the Scarecrow. "Even in the form of a green monkey, she's a very clever person, and I'm sure her wits will show her how to get plenty to eat." "Don't worry about her," advised Dorothy. "She didn't worry about you, and her condition is no worse than the condition she imposed on poor Woot. She can't starve to death in the Land of Oz, that's certain. And if she gets hungry at times, it's no more than the wicked thing deserves. Let's forget Mrs. Yoop, for, in spite of her being a Yookoohoo, our fairy friends have broken all of her transformations." End of chapter 14.